Hey everyone, welcome back. We've got more of the North American LCS coming up, continuing with Gravity versus Enemy Esports. Now, Enemy Esports auto qualified for the LCS after winning first place from the Challenger Series Spring Split. So this is the first time that we're going to see them in a televised match against an LCS team.
True enough, and it is a team, but there's just a really familiar face on it as well. That's a whole bunch of team of new guys, and then Inox. He's coming back. He's in the LCS. He's changing lanes, though. He's going over to the mid lane, and honestly, he's had a lot more success in the mid lane. It's been a very positive move that's given Inox a lot more confidence himself. He stepped up. He's a big voice on the team now. He's a huge leader for them, and just he looks way happier as well.
Yeah, I mean, he's even like willing to give interviews and stuff. The guy's had a complete transformation since he was EG's top laner a few years back. Now, on the flip side, Gravity actually lost a lot of their veteran experience. During the break, jungler St. Vicious and AD carry Kopp both stepped down from active play, with Kopp actually taking in a coaching role with Gravity. But taking over in that bot lane is going to be Altec, who was previously with Winterfox last split. And in the jungle is Move, a Korean jungler who was with the Edward Gaming organization on their Challenger team.
Yeah, I mean, losing St. Vicious. Love him or hate him, St. Vicious was a very vocal person. So Gravity are losing that very strong shot-calling central voice. And now they are also grooming Bunny Fufu to be the new shot-caller for the squad. So in addition to adapting to that new AD carry to lane with, Bunny is also taking on the responsibility of leadership and shot-calling for the squad. So he's got a whole bunch of new stuff that he's got to deal with.
Yep, so a lot of growth required now for Gravity and a lot of learning for these guys as they mature into their new roles and new teams for some of these players. Right now we're going to check out the starting lineups though, and on the blue side is Gravity. Haunter in the top lane, Move in the jungle, Keen in mid, Altec on AD carry, and Bunny Fufu on support.
And on the red side, it's Enemy Esports. Up top is Flares in the jungle, Trashy, mid Inox, AD carry Otter, and support Body Drop.
So this is going to be a game to watch for sure. The first test for both these teams, and it's going to be an interesting test because, of course, we haven't seen how Enemy fare against any of these LCS teams. We don't know how good new Gravity is as well.
Yeah, I mean, we talked about how it's a lot of new guys to the scene here. Flares, though, he actually got to sub into the LCS a little bit.
It's true.
In the top lane. He's also ranked number one right now on solo queue for whatever that's worth.
Yeah, he's been there for the last, like, 6 months.
Yeah.
He's been all
him and
that.
Double Lift are going 1-2 right now, one game apart. Yeah. But, yeah, he's a very strong top laner, and we'll see what Enemy can do here because Trashy, their jungler, also a lot of hype behind him coming from the Challenger circuit, just pretty much because he's Danish.
Yeah, well, I mean, when we see players like Svenskeren and Santorin and Bjergsen and Incarnation, we realize that Denmark has a lot of really good players out there. So Trashy, I actually got to talk to him when he was in the Challenger Finals, actually, I guess a few weeks ago or whatever. And I asked him about like all these other Danish junglers around him. He's like, yeah, you know, me and Svenskeren and Santorin, we were all kind of just orbiting around each other as we were all these sort of aggressive junglers that all wanted to take over games.
Yeah.
And then just based on which team we went on, we had to take on different roles. So he's like, Santorin became a supportive jungler because he had Bjergsen on his team, and like Santorin kept trying to carry everyone. I kind of went back and forth because he's like, I want to support Inox a whole bunch. I think he's really good, and Flares wants to carry all the time as well. So Trashy, actually, I remember also, just to continue on with him, he was in the European Challenger circuit back in 2014, and he was on an old team, Reason Gaming, and he was like the only good player on the team, and he would like hard carry games on like Wukong and Nocturne. And I was like, oh my god, this guy's so good. He's just held down by his teammates. Then he got on better and better teams. He played on the team that eventually became H2K, but Lulix replaced him, and now he's on Enemy Esports. And just, he has been a very explosive, very dominating, at least for the Challenger Series jungler. And now him on the professional stage. Again, players with similar skill to him, like Santorin. You know, I expect good things from Trashy here.
Interesting. Very interesting. I'm excited to see how he performs against Move here because, you know, coming from EDG, they just won MSI, a very prestigious team. He was on the sort of sub-squad. And he is Korean, and they all had, you know, of course, all of their foreign player spots filled on their maid team. But he did get to play a bit in the second tier. Now, he is a guy that is very hard to find any extra information on besides solo queue. Because of that fact, and because it's really hard to get, you know, any information on their scrim results and stuff like that, I was talking to Kopp, who is now, as you can see behind him, the coach of the team, who's going to be handling picks and bans. I was like, you know, give me some more information on Move. You know, why'd you guys even pick this up? How'd the tryouts go? And he's like, well, he's good at League of Legends, so that's why we picked him up. All right, that's a good reason.
Yeah, good. So and?
That's what we got for him. That's why he was picked up.
It just sounds like
Kopp has a lot of faith in him.
Great. Well, that's good.